wanted to take a quick minute to evaluate GDP, see what it's useful for, and see why maybe it may not be the best measure of economic activity. One of the things that GDP is used for is to measure the standard of living over time. If we take real GDP, we divide it by the population, we actually get something known as real GDP per capita, and this gives us the average value of goods and services that the average person can buy and enjoy. By using real GDP, we actually take away any influences of inflation or price changes. Now, the limitations of real GDP, and these are quite important. Household production underestimates GDP. Now, household production includes things like preparing meals, doing chores. These activities are not actually traded in markets and are thus not actually counted in GDP. These emissions, like I mentioned, they result in an underestimation of total production. And this also means that the growth rate of GDP is overestimated. Here's an example. Let's say that you regularly mow your lawn. This has some sort of economic value, mowing your lawn. But let's say next year you decide, I don't want to do this anymore, and you hire somebody to mow your lawn. Now the difference is, you were getting the same value of mowing your lawn when you were doing it, and you're still getting the same value of your lawn being mowed when someone else is doing it. Now the only difference is that you're paying someone to do it, and so now it's actually counted as GDP. Whereas the actual amount of economic activity has not really increased, it's just that it's now counted. That's the only difference, which is why the household production actually underestimates GDP. We also have underground economic activity, and this is just activity hidden from the government to either avoid taxes or if it's illegal. And this is not counted in GDP because it's unreported, so the government actually has no way of knowing that it's happening. And so that actually underestimates GDP. There's more activity going on than we have actually counted. We also have the discount of leisure time. And leisure time is considered an economic good, and it is actually considered to add to the standard of living. The more leisure time we have, the better off we're actually considered to be. Leisure time must be just as valuable, if not more, than actual wages, because if not, then the person would work more. And leisure time is not accounted for in GDP, and so there's another limitation. We can't really measure the standard of living accurately without counting for leisure time. We also have environmental quality, and this is extremely important. Economic activity directly influences the quality of the environment. Depletion of non-renewable resources, clearing of forests, and these things have major environmental consequences, but none of these are actually taken into account. And so GDP is in fact a lot higher than it otherwise would be. GDP is reported as a lot higher than it should be because of the destruction of the environment. So that was the lecture on measuring GDP and economic growth.